Hi everyone, today you will learn how to correctly configure the Mac OS Firewall to block incoming connections and protect your Mac from online threats. The firewall configuration will be the same whether you use Mac OS Ventura or Sonoma. So let's get started. To access the firewall settings, launch the system settings by going to the Apple menu and selecting System Settings. Next, click the network icon located in the left sidebar and select the firewall pane. Turn on the toggle switch. This will activate the default settings to provide you with basic protection. However, you can have more control over the firewall settings by clicking on the options button. The first option is to block all incoming connections. This rule is too strict, and enabling it may cause some applications to stop working. File sharing or remote access services will be blocked along with incoming network connections. I recommend keeping this option turned off unless you are in an environment that requires blocking all incoming connections. In that case, turn it on. Otherwise, it is best to leave it turned off. To control incoming connections to a specific application or service, use the following option. For instance, to block incoming connections to the music app, click the plus icon and select music from the list. Then choose open. And the app will appear in this window. Next, select Block or Allow Incoming Connections from the drop-down menu. If you want to add another app, simply click on the plus button again. Choose the app you wish to block, such as Photos. And click Open. It will be added to the list. You can now select Block or Allow from the drop-down menu. If you want to remove an app, click on it to select it, and then click on the minus button to remove it. By default, the following two options are enabled. The first option permits all built-in software like mail, FaceTime, weather, and services signed by a valid certificate authority to receive incoming connections. I agree with the default setting and choose to leave it turned on. The second option enables automatically downloaded signed software to receive incoming connections without displaying a warning. This means that if you download a third-party app from the internet, like Microsoft Word, your Mac will allow incoming connections to enter your system. However, if the toggle button is turned off, your Mac will display a warning, such as this one, asking, "Do you want the application Microsoft Word to accept incoming network connections?" You can then choose Allow or deny the connection. If you trust the developer, click on Allow. If you are unsure, click denied. You can allow incoming connections once you are confident that the app is not a threat. In case you accidentally allow incoming connections, don't panic. Simply launch the Firewall application and select Block from the drop-down menu. To enable sharing services such as file sharing or printer sharing on your system, first navigate to the General option on the left side pane of your settings. Click on Sharing and then turn on both file sharing and printer sharing. You will notice that both sharing services are listed in the Firewall application window, but there is no block incoming connections option for sharing services. If you want to remove them from this window, you need to go back to General, click on Sharing, and turn them off there. This will make them disappear from the Firewall application window. Enable Stealth Mode. The Stealth Mode prevents your Mac from responding to incoming connections or ping requests. It makes it difficult for hackers and malware to discover your Mac. However, it will still allow incoming requests to authorized applications. I will click the toggle button to turn it on and add another layer of security. You may already know that the macOS Firewall is designed to block incoming connections. However, if you are looking for a way to block outgoing connections, I have made a detailed and easy to follow tutorial for you. The Firewall application is entirely free and the tutorial is worth checking out. Take advantage of this opportunity to learn about a free Firewall app and how to use it. Don't miss out. I will leave the link to this tutorial in the description box below this video. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.